Please mute your registering guys. So before I could start, guys, so I want to explain a few things, guys. So why this, these are the top five wall. So as you can see on your screen, the leaders with Palo Alto Networks, Fortinet, Checkpoint, software technology. This is the top five wall in the world. So now, then the Cisco comes. Miss, out of top five firewall in the world is fourth place is what you are learning today, right? So, but thing is, why the Cisco has been still not good in firewall? Because it all the firewalls, so it has been derived from Cisco. The concept, the technology, what are the things you are learning, like configuring routing protocol, security policies, okay, and even like VPN, okay. Same thing we are doing for Checkpoint as well as Palo Alto. So that's the reason I told you, so be very good in your NAT, ACL, and VPN. Routing is default, guys. That you should know how to configure. Okay, even if you don't know, you can Google it, you can configure your routing protocols. So from now, as you can see, so this is the latest one. I think this is 2021 till November. So this I will share you in the Teams. Like if you want, you can refer this. Top firewall. This other firewall in which they are leading in the network firewall report. So if you open this, and Fortinet still is not up to the mark, like vendor products score for the enterprises data center. So 1-1 firewall has got the different capabilities. So some firewalls are very good in data center. So, you know, data center, it has the data like read and write. Okay? Writing the data and fetching the data from the data center, which required the high throughput of the each bandwidth. Even it should support your throughput of your ports. That's the reasons they have very good compatibility at the Fortinet. Nessie, Checkpoint, Juniper, Palo Alto, Cisco, Versa Networks. This all of which I think Sophos, Watchdog, Sophos, I don't know what is the different firewalls. Sonic Wall was good once upon a time, I think 7-8 years back. So now it has been come down. These are the shareholders which you can see. The contribution in the data center. Have you seen the Facebook data center, guys? Anybody in the YouTube or the Facebook?
I've seen IBM.
It is there, I think, most probably in Greenland and Finland. One unit of the this one Facebook is equal to one football stadium. So they have, I think, more than 1,000 units. It's very huge. Its data day by day is increasing, right? It's take photo and upload, take video and upload, right? So this is just basic information, like just to understand. So today's now, guys, I'll share this document right now. Okay. So this is the lab panel, so we should follow it. So first understand the topology, what we are going to do. The firewall which we are using here, okay, we are using 5506 firewall. Okay. So we can see here. So here running the external host, means outside. Is not belongs to, okay. And this what we are seeing, that is outside. What we are seeing here means that is connected for the ISP. That is connected for your ISP sites. Means that is outside means security level is zero. This is the inside. This is a DMZ. So in this switch, it is connected a lot of your servers, like web server, Exchange server, your DHCP servers. And this is your internal network. Okay, we can say this is your inter network. And this we can say intranet. intranet. Now, what is the objective of this lab? So what we are trying to configure here? What are the things? So here R3 is the external one, which is not belongs to our company. Through ISP, we are connecting. So here, what we are going to learn here, we are going to configure a DHCP, routing protocol, AAA, okay, SSH, these are protocols. So if you check the objective, so part one, part two, he has made the four parts here. Okay, the first part is going to configure the hostname interface for the IP address for the router, switches, and PC. Okay. So how we are going to do? So do you sync with me or how if I share this document? Or first I will do and
then you share the document.
Share the document. So what I'm planning, I'll share the document right now. Okay. Fine. So first understand the part one basic configuration assigning the IP address, configure stat. Including the default route between R1 and R2 and R3. First, understand the case, guys. Is it okay now? The first part is the configure static route, default route, R1 and R2. Means whenever you start doing the lab, okay, your topology is there in your mind. Okay, which interface is connected, what IP address I should give. Right? That's the reason I explained about the topology. And next part is enable HTTP and SSH access for the R1. Okay, you should enable the HTTP. So SSH. So SSH, I'll tell you how to access this. Okay. So configure PC host IP address. Okay. IP address will configure DHCP, will get automatically. Verify the connectivity between the host, switch, and router. Say the basic configuration of the router, switch, and panel. The part one. So in part two, what we are going to do? Access ASA firewall console, because first thing you are not going to configure the firewall. First thing is router and switch and PC. That's it. Means you have to assign the IP address. That's nothing you have to do. Second part is you have to access your firewall. Okay, so console via the hosting. So let me tell you about the how to do the console access. Okay. So please remember me how to do the console access using console cable. So which I didn't taught you about how to access the console cable. And then determine the ASA versions, interface, and licensing. So if you want, you can check the licensing, like which license is there. Because, you know, some Cisco is very good for the business. Okay. You can buy the device. Okay, you know, the VPN has got a lot of advantages. Okay, if you got two sites, okay, they'll give default fee of cost configure. If three sites, they'll ask you money, buy the license. Understood? Because of this, many company has been come up. I never heard the Palo Alto 12 years back. VPN, a lot of things is there. You talk about Cisco Nexus switches, okay, if you want to create a lot of VDCs, virtual device context, it is nothing but a VLANs, creating a VLANs. Okay, there we can divide. So one port as it said, one company is enough, one port. The throughput, the capacity, or the output is very huge, 100 gig. It's enough for one company, right? So that kind of switches is there. To create a lot of VDCs, so Cisco people ask to buy the license. This is how the technology will make money. Okay. So next thing is determine the file system and content flash. So how to check the flash? I think show memory. So what are the image file we are using? So clock rate, hosting, this we can give it. So in part three, basic configuration of the ASA firewall interface security levels. So as I told you, better idea is always give the name of the firewall and domain name. So configure login and enable the password. Set a date, time, month, and year. Okay. So by default, it will come. Once we connect, it will come. So if it is wrong, it is showing means, so better to configure it. So configure inside and outside interface. Test connectivity to the ASA. So configure access to the ASA. So this will do it. Just add the PC to the firewall, connect with the console. Okay, that's it. I'll tell you this. Okay, so after this, so now the part 4, 5, 6 is important. So configure the static default route to the ESA, configure PAT and NAT. So modify your MFPF application inspection services. Means when you are going to access the WHTTP, HTTPS, means there is a part of application, right? It's asking to enable that. Then you configure DHCP. So authentication, authorization, and accounting. Okay. SSH. Then try to configure the SSH to access the remote one. Means the router 3, which you asked, router 3, which is connected on PC, that is a remote one. Okay. From there, you should be able to allow them access to your firewall. Remote access.
Outside.
Okay. Then configure the DMZ, static NAT, and ACL. Okay. So this is the scenario, guys. Okay. So right now, I'll share you this document in the Teams. Where is the Teams? Recent. Okay, so you can open this document I have shared you. Okay, let's open this topology. First, understand the topology, guys, before you start doing the lab. It has got around 26 pages. This is one lab. We can do it. That is not big. Okay. The first thing is what we should do. First, connect it. First, connection is required. So connection without connection, how we can get IP address? No problem. First, you can take router, then connect your this thing. And make sure connect your which firewall. That is important. See here. So which one I have connected? 06 this is. Let me check this. This is 05. The very basic configuration, right? Maybe I think next I have got it. This password. So I have given this password, guys, for this thing. If you type, check once again, exit, enable it, last the password. Okay, this is under what a console password. Okay, I have given Cisco show run, which I already yesterday I configured. So these are the things I have configured. Now you have to do, we are going to do this all now. Getting sleepy. But why I'm not getting sleepy? Pavitra, you are getting sleepy. No. Because this is a big topology, guys. Before you go for the lunch, I want to complete this. Sorry.
Dinner.
Your second break. So that you can have time and can have some half an hour nap. Right. Okay. So let's connect it, guys. So PPT already sent you. Yes, I'll send you. Yeah, I'll send you. So what I'm going to do, this is a smart guy, right? Copy and paste. So I'll be using So as we can see, this is the task, guys. Okay, so let me check whether it is already exists there. So right now I'm using the very basic firewall configuration. So Cisco, write erase. Let it be this firewall, guys. Fine, because just assigning the IP address, you want me to teach for the routers? You save my time. Yes, Poonam, you are logging. Did you log in? Okay, you are watching there. Okay, you can see the same task what I said to you, guys. You can see on your screen. So configure R2 security appliances, basic setting, and the firewall using the CLI topology. So first thing is set the firewall interface level, security level first, inside and outside. Then configure routing, then address translation, inspection policy using the CLI. Configure DHCP, AAA, SSH, DMZ, static NAT, ACL, right? Lot of things is there. The commands which I have already pasted here, so that I plan to share this file later, not now. Okay, how to configure each and everything I have mentioned here. Right, so that we will not get any confusion. Now, if I send this hardly, I think 2 pages, because I have made the zip file for you. Right, so that 2 pages, we can complete all topology. Because basic topology, it takes, I think, 4 pages. For assign the IP address, 4 or 5 pages. Because I have done this very old document. I think it is almost, I think, totally as old document. Yeah, this file was old because this is a base first time you're doing, right? That's the reason I took this document for it, because I was searching yesterday. Okay, what is the first job? So let me start the configuration. I think router is completely down now. So it's asking pre-configure the firewall now through the interactive prompt. No. Right, guys. So we can see here, I have not set any password to the firewall. Right. So one more thing I want to tell you, how to access the console access. Okay, let me connect this. So here you should connect RS-232, okay, then console, okay, to the console, okay, then you can able to access your firewall from here. And you should not go to command prompt here. So you should go to your terminal, okay, and it's a default setting, press okay. So now you can able to access your firewall. Show interface IP brief. It's not required because, you know, when you are using the rack, okay, so you can't access directly the firewall, right? So we have to take your laptop there. I think he has seen some photos also, right? The data center is a lot of boys and girls, they're standing the laptop and connecting. So they will use this console key.
Firewall doesn't have it.
Yes, is there? Is there, right? You can see. No, it is there. Look like same. This one. Look like same because I found I'll show you some firewalls. Double 5056, right? So this is a firewall, guys. If you check. This firewall, I think, yeah, this one.
This one box.
Yes. It's very old one. 25,000. That is refurbished. Okay, so when you are going to buy, it means it will be 2-3 lakhs, this one box. I have this firewall at my home, this one.
Whether
Sorry, didn't get question.
CLI will open then. CLI traffic loosen. Directly you can do it in the firewall or should be.
Laptop or PC. So directly they will not give access. It is not recommended. Even for internal engineer also they will not give the access. Take your laptop and access and do. Like this will connect always. Because when I used to do, like this will connect. How I have connected.
What company will have one firewall or
one? I think two. Two required. Active standby. So one fail, once it will be up. Two firewall required. For enterprises network.
This company.
I think I didn't check the data center. I think it is there in 13th floor, right? Okay. So I think Mr. Hari Krishnan, I think he asked me to show you the data center which is there. Today in the meeting, I will take you one day. We'll see the rack, data center, switches, firewall, Nexus switches. Okay, I'll show you that. Industry visit. In the industry visit, they will not show you this. They'll show you the picnic, like sceneries all in there. Because I was also part of your college manager. I know what they will show you. Fine. So first thing is what? What I should do? Assign the IP address, right? Okay, so right now, I don't want to disturb this routers, which is already assigned. Please understand. So this is my network as, and this is your VLAN 20. Because whenever you see, okay, VLAN 1, 2, 3 VLANs. So this all the inside, this is the outside. Okay, which already configured. This is my ISP IP address as per the document he has given. Okay, slash 29 means your subnet mask 255.255.255.248. Right? So with miss example he has taken. You can take any IP address. So what is the first job I should do? Okay. This router already I assigned the IP address. Okay, I don't want to assign. For the PC, let me check. So it's already assigned the IP address. Okay. Check one by one. So IP interface. So here also it's already assigned. So just one IP address enough, right? 172.16.3.1. Okay. And serial interface 10.2.2.1. And check with this router. Okay, fair enough. This is connected. 10.2.2.2. This one. So this guy has been assigned with so ISP 209.165.200.225 with this interface. We can see gigabyte 0/0, right? This interface and 10.10.1 is this interface. Okay. So if you want, I will write it down here. Okay, so that will not get confused. Better to take this copy and take this and paste it. This is, I think this guy. One guy just assigned the IP address, nothing I had done, right? Okay, so let's check with the firewall. So in the firewall right now, it's totally nothing I have configured. Show run. So this is already has configured. Telnet with this thing. So we can remove this. Okay. So I have not configured anything, right? Can you see? So nothing is configured with the firewall. So what is the first job? He's asking to check some basic command. Can you check? Can you see? So this is the chart. Like as per this document, it has to be assigned IP address. If you check for the firewall, so gigabyte/2 should be 1.1 with the wildcard mask. And 1/1 is this IP address, 1/3 is this IP address, the firewall. So let's assign this IP address, right? Okay, how to use this document, guys? So please go down. It will show you, help you to how to give the commands. You can see, right? So from the router to switch, which we already configured. Okay, and for the R1, R3, he has configured with default routing. Can you check that one? Whether we configure default routing? So which is R1? This is R3. R2. Check. Show IP route. So in the firewall, how we have to check means show route. That's it. No, show IP route. Means IP we should not use in the firewall. Okay. So we can see here, yeah, he has configured with the OSPF, right? Can you see? With the area 0. So area 0. So how to remove this routing protocol? No router. No done. Okay, it's not just removed, right? Okay, now check with this router. So here also OSPF has been configured, right? So no router, OSPF 1. Done. So he has configured with the OSPF. Yes, we are removed. Okay, rest all the IP address is same. Show IP interface brief. Okay, so this is the IP address which has connected. Think battery low. Who will give the battery? Guys, you are following. Okay, so let's follow this document. So he has configured with the router 1 and 3 default route 1 and 3. So tell me which is 1 and 3. Check show IP route. So how to configure, right? So config team IP route 0.0.0.0. Who will tell this? I am in router 1 now. Poonam, can you tell me what should be my gateway for this one? One dot. So your topology is there, it should be in your mind always. Right? Then only you can able to do it. Wrong IP address means it will route to the different one, but it will accept your command. Okay, but it will not update the routing updates to your neighbor router. Okay, Rukhaya, can you tell me? Tisha. Sirisha, tell me the IP address I'll type. Whatever you tell, I'll type here. Huh? 10 dot 0 dot 0 dot 0. Then that's it. You want to give the question mark? Can I press enter? See the topology, man. Look at the topology, what you should type. So blindly doing, because I know, I think today I will check your assessment, man. I check one or two people. I will check your assessment. I am in R1, right? Okay. So default routing. So what IP address I should give? Huh? Ten dot zero. One dot. You want to give the zero? More network. Network or big recommended is interface name, exit interface name. Yeah. The topology is this. Right now, I am in router one, guys. Can you see my cursor there, right? Right now, I am in this cursor. I want to do the default routing. Means what other networks comes to me? So I want to route it. Fine, default routing. Any network, any mask, any class. Right? Yeah.
For ASA firewall, does it also access?
No, it's not like this. What do you configure default routing? So router we can configure OSPF, REAP, PHRP.
I mean, you have to go outside.
From ISP sites, they'll not configure the REAP OSP. They'll configure default routing.
You have to do routing even to the firewall.
Yes, sir. Understood, guys? So let's move on. There's a lot of things I opened. So what else I should do now? Where is my R1? Then what text? Then R1? So in R3, I should configure, right? Right. So let me take the R3. So here, show IP route. I think nothing is there. Okay. So go to global configuration IP route. 0.0.0.0.0.0.0. Okay. So what should be the next up, you can see topology here, guys.
No.
10 dot?
2
dot? 1 or 2? We can give one note. He's in the hexagon router. 2, I think. Maybe I think 2 that IP address. Done. Okay, then do show IP route, right? So now we have configured with the default route. Fine. So let me check with this router. Show IP route. So here nothing is configured. So what is asking us to do now? Next, configure your static route from your R2. Okay. See, because you know default routing always they configure from the ISP sites. Right now we are in the ISP network. We are not into your internal networks. Your internal network is, I told you, this is your internal network. Only this part. This is all our ISP site. And trusted network. They'll not do the your this thing. OSPF, RIP, HRP, they'll not configure for you. They'll configure default routing or static routing. That's it. Okay. But they'll give an IP address, right? Static IP. When you buy the internet, they'll give the IP address. Okay, over that IP address, where which interface you configured, from there they'll configure your static routing. So which network you're running inside, okay, class A, B, C, okay? So to reach to this network, go via this side, okay? Or default routing. You configure anything class A, B, C, doesn't matter. Okay, come to me, so I'll take to the ISP. That is the logic here. Okay, so logo gateway is here, right? If you buy the internet connections, they will give the lease line one IP address. IP address is unique for whom? No. Once you configured with the ISP, with the static routing, you did not configure toward the for USP one, America one, London. It's not like this. Once you configured with your gateway, your company gateway, okay? So you come to this gateway, your network hit to me, so I will take to the world. Understood? So to take that connection, that is the lease LAN internet connection. It is very expensive. The IP address is unique. Yes. Translation will be done. IP address translation will be done. And we are allowing by using ESCs. Allow and access the internet. Once and twice, if you do, is easy, guys. Don't think because I'm going very slow to understand each and every step. Because I did in just in 30 minutes, this all. Okay. So static routing, how we have to configure, please understand what, where, from where to where he has configured. Okay, this is a static routing from R2. He has used the exit interface, is recommended. Right? So we can see, guys, here, this is the ISP IP address. Can you see? Bruno, where are you? Why static routing, you asked, right? Yes. Because when you take the internet connections, they will give an IP address. That IP address is unique. Okay. So if you take internet connections, do you know previously they will not take anything. Nowadays, they take your photo, Aadhaar card, father card, mother card, every card they will take. Right? Have you seen? So I got 2 line connection at my home. So they took my photo. Okay. Yeah, I asked them, do you want my side view, front view, top view? No, sir, don't know. I'm only front view. Don't take. Because, you know, it is a government restriction. Because, you know, your internal networks, your mobile phone, tab, laptops, your internal network, your devices, okay, is going to represent with that IP. With that IP, they'll trace you. But why he's telling you, seeing you and telling you.
Actors like
this. Understood, guys. That the reason we are going to configure a static routing. See, this is the IP address, and this is the other network, three networks, and serial interface. So let us configure this. So where is my, I think R2, right? Okay, so let's configure this. Configure IP route. So 209.165.200.248. Okay, so he has used this serial interface, I think, let me check. No. Even RIP also we can configure with the SIP interface.
Yes, they don't have to stack it for this and for ISP it's default. So basically if you
means static routing means our network is 200. Okay, imagine this is our company network, and there is another company different network, they have 172 range, means two internet connections. Some Airtel or any, they have your two connections. Okay, we are ISP side now. So one side from entity, one side from 172. That is what we are doing. Static routing. They are not configured default routing app. These are assessment questions I'm going to ask. ISP people will never configure with your default routing. Default routing means what happened? Use your logic and common sense.
You're not giving subnet
mask. IP clash to that. What ISP people, they'll not configure the default route.
Because they won't know IP is since it's any network, any device, there won't be any kind of there won't be security, any network, any device.
Sorry, you said
no security. Any network, any device, so anyone can access.
It will become free of cost, right? Means like you can fly this anywhere, no flight tickets. That is default routing from ISP sites. It is good, right? Means when you configure DSP, ISP people default routing means you are allowing them to free to the internet. You use any class A, class B, it doesn't matter. Okay, when you come to me, I'll take the internet connections. Why they will do like this? They'll not do like this. Default routing will not configure. They'll configure only static route. From your side, you have to configure the default route so that we should all different classes IP address they can route to the internet.
With an extra
example.
Sorry.
See, the reason why they are not configured with the default routing is means you are allowing to access their internal network as well as external network. They're allowing ISP network is very huge, right? So they'll allow you. If they configure with default routing, what happened? That's one point. Second point means even you can access their internal network as well. Second issue. Okay, even they can access the all internet connections without internet connections. Just connect to the line. Okay, DHCP will be configured automatically. You get the IP address. You can access internet like storing the this on Wi-Fi man on your Wi-Fi. These things. Automatically DHCP IP address will get that. Some people without username password, they'll configure default, which is not recommended. So automatically you get internet access, right? The one logic. Okay, the serial interface, I don't know which is the serial interface. Let me check the topology. Right now I am in this order. So which serial interface I should type here? 0/0/ zero or one in compact performance. What is this?
That is because both are serial 0/0/0.
Serial number, right? He's asking 0/0/0. I think one, I think, right? I think it's zero. default road without gateway, it is not permitted the point to point, may impact your performance.
Let's show the IP, the green IP.
Do show IP. So one is 00, one is 002. Right, one is 00, one is 001, right? Okay, so let's do that. It's correct, right? No problem. Okay, and one more is IP route 172 dot, I think 16 dot, I think 3.0 network, right? Let me check the gateway. Zero dot zero dot zero dot one. No problem. Show IP route. So it has been learned the static route, right? Right. It has been learned the static route. So what next I should do now? Enable HTTP servers and configure the user account. So crypto password, crypto these things. Okay. So how to do this, guys? This is the command. It is mentioned this thing. So IP HTTP server. Where you should configure in R1, okay, which is R1, R2. This is R1, right? This is R1, right?
Yes.
So what I should configure? HTTP, IP HTTP, to check the command, what is it? Yes. Okay, it's not taking. This command is not working. Enable HTTP access the router using the IP HTTP command. Check the console with you. I don't know why it's not working. This. Okay, this HTTP is not supporting this one. Later, watching this command, I think I also skipped it. I didn't configure this because you know it's not supporting this. You can see, right? You can see his IP, there's no HTTP here. Right. What happened, man?
Default.
Okay, so I think HTTP, this is not supporting this router. We can skip this. Let's configure with security password for VTV, then crypto key. I think this also is not required. As of now, we'll configure this console for login. This will configure for the R1. So line console 0. Okay, login local execution timeout. We'll give minutes, 5 minutes and 0 seconds. Okay. So login sync. Do you know, guys, what is line BTY? Which I configured this one? Yes, right? Means we are just allowing to access this my router to remote people. This is the command for the console. Same thing like telnet, how you configure it. Right? Do you remember telnet, how to configure? Same thing here, nothing different. Same thing, you can check here. Okay, line BTY 0 to 4. Okay, login local transport input SSH, execution timeout 5 and 0, 5 minutes and 0 is a seconds. Okay, so I'll give just 2 and 0. Okay, I don't want to give less. Okay, enable. Oh, algorithm is not working. And this kind of very basic command, guys. I think if you change the router, it works. Other router, it works. Especially 4331 router, it works. It works. I don't want to use that command, and this is not so important command. So let's jump to the other part of the session. He has given some command. If you want, show version, which I already did, right? Show version. It will show you the details of your router IOS. Show file system. Whether this command will work. So now here, jump to the firewall. Now I'm firewall. Show files. So nothing, I think we have got just one file. This is the file size. Okay, then show memory. Show flash. Which flash means your operating system, guys. This is the operating system. This is the OS file. So remember that in the firewall, same like your switch and router, firewall doesn't have any hard disk. So this image file, this is the operating system which will be stored in the flash memory, which is look like your USB backside will be connected. Okay. Show run. So we can give this command, guys, because I don't want to give this one host name and this thing. Let me show you this one also. It's not required right now. For 50, domain name, I'll give our company name, dot in password. I think host name Cisco ESA. Password Cisco. That's it. I will password. Guys, you're following me or just you are discussing with each other? Do you know what I did here? Other guys, last years, Vidya and Vaishnavi Shetty,
you know what password
is? What is the password, man? Okay, so Cisco. We access because you know after 2 minutes it will exit again. 2 minutes it will exit because if anybody try to access means it lost the password. Okay, so that the reasons recommended accessing by PCs by using terminal.
What's the difference?
Both the difference. Because you know, when your remote guy is accessing your firewall, which you are going to do now, what happens means that your firewall is going to close every 2 seconds, 5 seconds. What
you're doing? If you're doing it directly in the CLI,
directly
in firewall, it's closed.
Yes, close. 2 seconds of whatever you configure, 5, 2, 5, whatever distance. Directly accessing means who will do the direct access? Internal engineers only, right? Okay, this command helpful the people who are accessing remotely your infrastructure. This command is very helpful. Okay, but both we can do commands from here and there, no difference. Both are same. And we should not go to the command prompt here. We should go to terminal. Yes, it will go to the your device command prompt, not to the firewall command prompt. So what are you asking to do next? Domain name security hack given. Block rate, I don't want to set. Okay, so now here the firewall configuration, guys. Okay, so from here, I'm going to configure your firewall configuration. You want break? $335. Okay, all of you take the break. Okay, go to washroom. Okay, so take the water and put it on your face.
Stop recording.
It's recording.